Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another Euler's method problem today. This one asks us to consider the following initial value problem, y prime equals x over y. They give y of 0 equals 2 is the initial condition. And delta x, they ask us to use delta x equal to 0.25 to find y of 1. So let's go ahead and get started. As with any Euler's method problem, the first thing that we're going to want to do is start creating our table of values. So we always start with t of 0 and y of 0, and we get both of those values from our initial condition. 0 is always representing t here, and then 2 is what we use for y of 0. So we can go ahead and write those values in. Now that we've done that, we always pull those from the initial condition, we use delta x, whatever they've given us, to build out our column of t values. And the way that we do that, they've asked us to use the delta x, or change in x, as 0.25. So what we're going to be doing is adding 0.25 to the previous value of t each time, and we're going to do that until we get to, because this is y of t, so until t equals 1. So let's go ahead and start adding 0.25, so 0 plus 0.25 is 0.25. 0.25 plus 0.25 is 0.50. T of 3 is obviously going to be 0.75. And T of 4 is going to be equal to 1. And now we know that we can stop because we've reached this value here, which is what we're trying to estimate when T is equal to 1. So this is going to be our full T column. And now we know that we are going to have to find y of 4. So we can go ahead and write these values in here. And now we're going to go through step by step with Euler's method to approximate y of 4. So each of these is going to be determined from the following formula. The Euler's method formula is quite complicated in most calculus books, but it really doesn't need to be. The only thing really that you need to know is y of 1, and I'll go ahead and write it right here. Y of 1 equals y of 0 plus f of t0 y0 times delta x, or sorry, delta t. Okay, so this is the formula for y of 1 here, how we're going to find y of 1. And all this says is y of 0, so here's our y of 0 value. And then this part here is whatever you get when you plug in t0 and y0 to the original function, and then multiply everything times delta t, which we have. So let's go ahead and apply that here to y1. We have y of 0, so 2, which we pull from here, plus plugging in t0 and y0 to the original function. So we have x over y, and this is actually, this is going to be 0 over 2, because we're plugging in t values wherever we have x, and y values wherever we have y. So we'll get 0 over 2, and then we multiply that by delta t, which we have as 0.25. So that's our equation for y of 1. Now we just need to simplify that. Of course, this is going to be 0, so this 0 times 0.25 is going to be 0. That's going to go away, and we'll just end up with 2. And then y of 2, and as we go each time here, all we need to do is add 1 to each of these little subscripts. So let's go ahead and get rid of that there. So if we add 1, this 1 will become 2, this 0 will become 1, and each of these will become 1. So if you just add 1, suddenly you have an equation for finding y of 2. So y of 2, you can see here we have use y of 1, which we solved for in the previous step, so again 2, plus, now we're plugging in t1 and y1 to the original function. So we plug in 0.25 for x and 2 for y. So we have 0.25 over 2, and we're multiplying that again by delta t, which is 0.25. So when we, and now you're going to have to bust out your calculator, when you do this math here, what you're going to get is 2.03125. Please remember that with Euler's method, it's extremely, extremely important that you keep every single one of the decimal places that you're given in your calculator. If you start rounding decimal places early, that error is going to be compounded every time, because you're going to be using this answer in y of 3, you'll use y of 3's answer in y of 4, and every time your answer will get farther and farther away from being accurate. So keep every single decimal place you have, even if it's 19 decimal places, write them all down, even though it's tedious, and then round at the very end for y of 4. Okay, so now that we have this, we can really start rolling. Again, adding one to each, but basically the pattern you're starting to see is you use the previous answer here first, 2.03125, plus, and then the two previous values again. So 0.50 over 2.03125, and we're multiplying by 0.25. And when you do the math there, you get 2.09 2788 88, and then again using the previous answer, 2.092788 plus again the two previous answers, 0.75 over 2.092788, and multiplying that whole thing by delta x, 0.25. And when we do that, we get 2.182381. So now that we're done, you can round this value, because it's your final answer, to two decimal places and just get 2.18. But remember to keep all the decimal places until you get to the last answer. So that's it. And even if you have, you know, through T10 and Y10, you just keep repeating that process using the values from the previous row to calculate the next value of Y until you get to your final answer, where T is equal to whatever is given to you in the question up here. That's it, guys. See you next time.